This is architect Ranganathan, and as you've seen in the web series poster, he will be taking today's webinar. I think let's start right away because we'll have less time in the end, so we can start. Thank you.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Good evening to all. Good evening to all who have gathered here. Am I audible? Am I audible, Rupesh? Am I audible to all of you?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes. A very warm good evening to all of you. Today we have gathered here to have a small motivation talk on architecture from a very different perspective, from a very simple and different perspective. So the art of designing from a learner's perspective is what we are trying to see. And we are, since it is a learner's perspective, this is a perception on architecture which would be useful for beginners in architecture, prospective students, and also faculties and other students to a certain extent. Okay. So this art of designing is the content of architecture which we study. Okay. This is not a study, it is training. Okay. Training in architecture for 5 years, what do we ideally train in is the art of designing. Okay, so this art of designing is the content which we go through this 5 years of training in architecture. Okay, so here I mentioned art, and before getting into the art of designing, I would like to brief on architecture as an art. Okay, architecture as an art. And before that, I would like to get into the definition of what art actually is. We are known to 64 type of arts here in Tamil Nadu from ages past. Number of arts are present in the classical history of India. So what actually is that? Art is something which is from within. First definition of art is something which is from within. Okay. The second part of what we're going to see in art is this character of art. Something which is present in architecture also, apart from being science, apart from being technology, architecture is also an art. Am I audible to all of you? So this art has some methods to be done, some methodology to be followed. What actually would this art be like is what we are going to cover today in this webinar. And say, for example, cooking, say a number of ingredients, difference in heating, difference in processing, you get a product, edible product. Okay, similarly, what is this process in architecture as an art, which will lead to a final product as design, as a building? Okay, this is what we are going to see today in this webinar. Okay, as we define art and as we confirm that architecture as a major component of art, let me go to the methods directly. Like children's play, let's take up an example of a children's play and what he does. Say I'm giving a child, say 10 cubes, 10 pyramids, some 5 spears. Okay, out of 10 pyramids, 5 are yellow, 5 are green. Out of 10 cubes, 5 are green and 5 are yellow. So now it's all put together and given to the kid, and he is ready to play with it. Okay, so I told art is something which is from within. Okay, a kid is something, a child is something who is well known to do things from within, and he's highly active in what he's doing. Okay, now he chooses certain things. Say he wants to categorize, say cubes of red color, pyramids of red color, cubes of yellow color. What is he actually doing? He is actually categorizing. He is learning. He is also learning. Say he is taking the cube, he is trying to feel its dimensions. He is trying to have a bite on of it to see how the material is. Okay. So basically he is learning, and the material is categorized based on the shape and color. Okay, this is the first step of learning, categorizing and analyzing, the basic scientific approach towards learning something. Okay, since I'm bringing in this aspect of learning from a child's perspective, because learning is an important aspect in architecture, very important aspect in architecture. Once you learn something, you get into the details and understand the nuances of what is there in the learning with relevance to the design which you're going to do. So now as the child plays, he analyzes. Now he wants, now we tell him, let's build something with these blocks. Okay, so he chooses, say, now he has learned the material, he has learned the shape, he has learned the color, he has categorized them like that. He has categorized them differently. Say he takes two cubes of red color, he takes two cubes of yellow color, he puts them one on top of the other. He takes a pyramid of yellow color, put it on top of the other. And what is he actually doing now? He is actually collating a number of things together, and he is synthesizing. He is synthesizing and he is collating a number of things together, and he is trying to create a form, or he is trying to create a form which is interesting for him. And this is an important step in designing from a perspective of art. This step is called synthesis. Synthesizing a number of things which you have learned and building a small block which the kid is doing. Okay, so this kids play which we took into example today was to understand these two stages of learning and synthesizing. Learning and synthesizing. Okay, you learn number of things, like the kids learn of the cubes and of the pyramids. You learn about the site, we learn about the material, we learn about the techniques, we learn about the tectonics. All these things we learn in a separate way, categorized way, then we tend to do a design. So out of all these learning, not everything is relevant. We are learning, we are analyzing the sense, we are getting into the details, seeing what is what. Say this is a nice sloping roof with a different angle from the half. Let's use this tectonic in our design. We are doing a small decision. Then we are going to the building material. So let's use CSCB for this building. The thermal property of the CSCB is going to be advantageous for our building. So we choose that. So condensed learning from all the analysis we have in this learning for doing an architectural design. After this learning is over, we get into the exercise of designing. Okay, many people say learning is also designing, but learning is a part which is substantially required, and designing is something, if you're a little more sensitive, something which happens after the learning. Okay, after the learning is over, we tend to synthesize a number of things. Synthesizing a number of things, say we take let's take an example of designing a living room. Okay, let's take an example of designing a living room. And we have done all the learning required for designing this living room in prior. So we need a space for 6 people to sit and talk is our need for designing the living space. Let's locate them centrally. Okay, let the door of the living room orient towards the north. Let's have a small balcony on the east, which will capture the early morning sun and which will capture the late evening moonshine. Okay, then let's have some furniture there, or let's have some space for exercise. Then let's have a room on the western side. This small room or this small alcove, you can call it an alcove. So let's have an alcove on the western side. This alcove can be used to tapping down the sun's rays during the evening. It would be nice to have a cup of tea with this yellow sunshine in the evening. So with appropriate shading so that the heat gain is not very much. Then let's have towards the south, near the entrance towards the dining, let's have a small zone where kids can... Let's have a family lounge where people of the family alone can sit and talk. Towards the northeastern corner, let's have a small corner where there is a small study table. There's toilets where a kid can do study activities, and the parents can monitor over study activities while being in the living room, a small study table. See, now this is a small narration of an art process, a small narration of a designing process, which has synthesized a number of information. I have put the living room into, say, five components of functions, small functions. First component is the interaction zone for six people. Second component is a living on the east. The third component is a small alcove on the west to capture the western sun or the evening sun. And the fourth component is the family lounge on the south. Sixth component is the a small study unit on the northeast. So these are five small components which I have synthesized together, and I'm trying to design a living room. And I've used a number of logics which I've learned, number of logics which I've synthesized from the learning platform. And I've sharpened them. Each component, say for example, the evening sun, I've put extra shading so that the sun does not come inside. On the eastern side, when I want to allow moonlight, I've had some roof openings. So it's a small things I sharpen, small things I do as components, I synthesize, and then I come out with a living room. So this is a process of synthesis, which. Am I clear? There seems to be some disturbance. Am I clear? Yes. But this is a process of synthesis, which is actually the art of designing. Art of designing in architecture is this process of synthesis. Once the synthesis is done, then ideas bloom out like a poem. The ideas bloom out because 100% learning is over. 100% synthesis and choice of many things are over. Now the design blooms out like a poem. Poem is something which comes just from in a second from nowhere. From nowhere, I will not call it. It comes from the intelligence. And then this, when number of such ideas, when it blooms like that, it's an innovative or a creative idea. Now, then aligning these ideas, again synthesizing these ideas, is also the art of design. It is not A, B, and C. It could be A, C, B. And the steps could be one after the other, or it could be even more flexible. Predominantly, the art of designing is this synthesis. People would not try to exactly tell what this art of designing is actually, but art of design is this synthesis, which happens in the intellectual. It happens in the intellect. Right. So when we understand how to synthesize, we became creators or we became innovators of design, and we can do a design which aptly or which fits with 100% fit to the context which we are designing. This product which we design is an output of our intelligence. We have synthesized, we have done an exercise, and it's an output of a synthesis. How do we, let me, a few more examples of how I call this as an art. Let me try to explain how I call this as an art. Say you're doing singing, or say you're doing dancing, or say you're practicing martial arts. There is step one, step two, step three. You combine step one, step two, step three. Again, you do a different step. So this aspect of synthesis is present in all kind of arts, whether it is singing, whether it is dancing, whether it is martial arts, whether it is cooking, or whatever kind of art which you practice. This aspect of synthesis is present, and which is predominantly used to define to define what the art of design is, art of designing is. Now this is definitely from a learner's perspective, because he has to know how to do things, how to do things, how to go about learning, how to go about synthesizing. So that is why I call it the art of designing from a learner's perspective. Now when this learning is 100%, when this synthesizing is original, then your poem or the design which comes out is unique, which is unique, which is something which is your own product, which is this is what is the actual art of designing, which you dance about and create a poem through synthesis and intellect. And this is what leads to a nice, unique design product. So this is what I'd like to say today as an art of designing. So Rupeshwar, how do we proceed further? Rupesh?
Yes, I can hear you. So, sir, thank you for the session, sir. I think that would have been really interesting for these people here. Now, I will just tell them to type their questions out in the chat, sir. So, whoever's question is popping out, you can just answer them. So, I would like the participants who are there in the call to open your chat, and you can just type any question you have which you want, sir, to answer. So, we'll answer that question. Or you can even unmute your audio and ask the question also. No problem. Anyways, we can do it. Anybody having questions, you can just type it out in the chat. Now I'm typing out. So somebody's having a question.
Should I open the chat? Sir. Should I open the chat?
Just click the chat, sir. It'll be visible on the side.
Yeah. Yes.
I think Gunanathan is asked whether the e-certificate will be provided, which I think, Gunanathan, we'll come back to you on that particular thing. You can contact us via a phone call so we can explain that to you in detail. Any other questions from this particular topic from anybody? You can ask the question or you can just type out the question. Thank you, Mansoor Ahmed. Okay. Mansoor Ahmed says he really enjoyed the session. Any Thank questions you have, Mansoor Ahmed? Yes, sir. Next question is there, sir.
Okay. So the various stages of designing, whether it is, so this is what in brief, so I'm here to project something as a motivation. I will not explain everything in critically detailed, but we may not have time. Basically, I'll tell you a few stages. First stage is learning. Within the stage of learning, we have a stage of analysis from a scientific perspective, of understanding the details, breaking down a number of parts and understanding the details. And the second step is synthesis. Synthesizing all the critical realized logics required for the design, and then synthesizing. So it is analysis, learning, analysis, realizing, and synthesis. Am I clear, Rajesh Agarwal, sir?
Rajesh Agarwal, you can reply, sir.
You're able to.
But actually, my question is that from a learner's perspective, if a student is studying in architecture, so these fundamentals are very good for theoretical purposes. But as far as designing is concerned, when he put a pen or pencil on the paper, then what should be the real things that could help them? Yeah, that could help him to draw that thinking which he is keeping in his mind, or the fundamentals in his mind, Are you getting my point?
I'm getting your point. Ideally,
this is a fundamental question. Because see, if a practitioner or an experienced person design something, then he can perceive the things very well, in a manner so that he could be able to draw on the paper. But from a learner's perspective, these fundamentals are quite heavy for them.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the drawing is concerned.
Okay. Certainly, I'm putting forward designing as an art. There are a number of skills which will help this art also, especially sketching. Like you told, sir, that after his learning is over, he'll take his pen, he'll sit on his sheet to start his designing. Okay. My advice to students who start design to start the stage of designing is to think small. My advice to them is to think small. You cannot imagine the whole building and innovate a design. Okay, the whole building is a response to a number of small functions. They mentioned a number of small programs. So I would advise students to start small, make number of small ideas, then collate them, then synthesize them, and then do a design. This is critical understanding is something which they should develop, and then the path of training in architecture would be easy, and the stage where to reach would also be a little faster. Am I clear, sir?
Yeah. Really helpful.
Yeah.
Thank you,
Rajesh Agarwal, sir.
Yeah.
So we have next question from Subiksha.
Subiksha, yeah. How to be a good designer and be unique. How to make a portfolio work in a unique way. How to be a good designer. A good designer, like I told you, talking within our purview of art of designing, a good designer is something, is someone who finishes the learning 100%. He realizes what he has learned, and then he takes over to do a unique design. So this 100% learning will give you the clarity, and then collating a number of ideas and inspirations will give you the ideal unique output. So the key is 100% learning. The clarity which you achieve by 100% learning. That is what I would say is a way to become a good learner, designer. Okay, because people might be if you're given a resident design now, maybe because of from your learning experience, you would be able to design it. If you are given a 5-star hotel now, you may not be able to design it. Or if you are given a large hospital to design, then what comes from in modern architecture is your ability to learn. Ability to learn and synthesize a number of things. Then you're trained, of course, you're training in architecture, your ability to sketch, your ability to synthesize comes into picture. The 100% learning is what which leads to good synthesis. And the synthesis is the art of designing. Am I clear, Subiksha? Yes?
Subiksha, you can answer in audio also. No problem. Was your question answered?
Your question is answered, Subiksha. Okay, can you go to the next question? Next question is on how to make a portfolio work in a unique way. It's also from Subiksha. The next question is also from Subiksha. You express your ideas clearly in portfolio. I'm sure you'll be able to do a nice combination, a nice presentation out of your works, portraying it. Also, do a good bit of writing with correct emphasis on what needs to be emphasized, what aspect of your work which you think is unique. You emphasize it. You know how to emphasize in drawing. You know how to emphasize in writing. Architecture students are well versed in such skills. So develop along with giving emphasis on the drawing, also emphasis on your writing, and while writing also emphasis on the correct reasoning which you are protruding towards your employer or the person who is going to view your portfolio. Yes, Rupesh.
Next question, Sendil Annamalai is having a question.
Annamalai. Yes. Yeah. Either from a learner's perspective or a teacher's perspective, the stages remain the same. Yeah. The stages remain the same, but from a teacher's perspective, we are supposed to contain the learner's perspective and weave around it. We have a little bigger task than the same stages from a learner's perspective. When we want to achieve an objective, say this is what we need to achieve, say in the stage of analysis, we need students to achieve this much learning, say about building construction techniques. We need students to achieve so much learning about a particular book, which we need to do a review. Okay, so we actually set the stage for this stages to happen. A teacher's role becomes little more trivial, while asking students to follow this path of learners from a learner's perspective. So yes, ma'am.
So Sendil Annamalai, is your question answered? We have another question. Okay.
Yeah, he has mentioned. Thank you. Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else having questions to sir, you can just type the questions or you can unmute your audio and ask the question, sir. Rajesh Agarwal.
Yeah. Yeah.
Sir, can you hear me? Rajesh Agarwal is asked a question.
Yeah. Designing presentation as student versus practicality as practitioners. I mean, not at practitioners, as practitioners, I believe. Practically as practitioners. Yeah. See, we have a number of procedures which are usually a part of architectural training. And I've very generally talked about these procedures as analysis, synthesis, and realization, which is very well applicable to the practitioners as well. The approach from being small, the approach from giving importance to learning, is something which the practitioners also need to have. For example, one of my research work was on Mayamudam. Mayamudam is a book belonging to Chola period. And it has all the proportioning system, all the type of towns, all the type of building configurations available readily. A person like an architect earlier just has to learn. He has to customize it to the site. That is the only job which they had. But the strength is learning and customizing the proportions to the site. But whereas practitioners now need to learn projects new, whether it is large scale or small scale. So the question of learning becoming important is also there. The same aspect of thinking small and starting from a small and designing it, collecting it artfully, is also a practitioner's ballgame. So a practitioner has also to follow these things to achieve a unique design. Yeah, that's the answer. Yeah. See. Yeah. So, shall we move to the next question, Rupesh? Rupesh?
Sir, I can hear you. Sir, next question, Sendin Allamalai has got another question.
Okay.
Guidelines on recording design process for
submissions. Yeah. Yes. Guidelines for recording design process for submission. You can maybe a few stages I can tell you about how to descend from small, how to descend from small, small ideas. Okay. Write a list of your, this is the concept stage of your descent, which you usually have, which you usually do. So this is a method of documenting this concept thinking itself. Say, for example, there's a library. The program is, let us not step into the library with a chappal. Okay, that is a program. Am I audible to all of you? Am I audible?
Yes, sir, clear. You're
clear, okay.
Clear, sir.
Yeah. So I need not step into the library with a chappal. Okay, so I need a small stand for all the shoes and chappals in front of the library. So this is the program of not stepping into the library with the chappal is a program. The need for a shoe rack is the design idea. Okay, so this is a method by which you can document your design ideas for each small programs which you can write down or which you have understood for your project. So you have a list of, you have a limit. I have the example which I told you, I had a list of at least 10 to 12 points and the representing ideas for all the 10 to 12 points. So when you make 12 points for a living room and you are able to make 12 equal design ideas, you will be able to achieve a good design. Yes, that is what I think is the answer for central anomalies.
Sir. Okay, sir. Okay, yeah. Sir. Thank you. So Subhiksha has got one question.
Yeah.
About theme.
Hmm. Yeah, theme plays a main role, but how to take a theme in a different way and say us the importance of it. Say us the importance. Because we, the designer, is must to know.
I think Subhiksha is asking about themes on the portfolio or things like that. Am I right, Subhiksha? Is it about the portfolio which you're asking, the themes? You can just unmute your audio and you can have a conversation also. It will be better for us to answer. Subhiksha, can you hear us?
Okay, let me try, Rubesh.
Sir, I just unmuted Subhiksha, so you can actually, she can also talk.
Okay.
Subhiksha, are you there? Can you hear me? Subhiksha, I've unmuted your audio. Can you hear me? Okay. Sir, I think you can answer a question and then we'll move to the next question.
Okay, fine. So a theme plays a main role, but how do we make a theme in a different way and say, see, being different is certainly a need to put forth your design and you achieve a name out of it and achieve a so more than there is something more needed than just being different. Okay, this is something you need to do a design which will fit to your context, 100% fit to your context. This is more important than being different. First point. Then you can, I'm sure you'll be able to be different a number of ways, do a number of themes. But this is what I would like to answer for being different. First, let's fit the context for being different and looking for different ideas to Austin Tandy's expression of our building and of our space. It's the next step. Yes?
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
So Rajesh Agarwal has got next question.
Okay.
Yes.
From good design is asked. Yeah. What would you think is a good design and what do you think good design and why? Okay. Okay. Very briefly, I'll answer because there are a number of good designs. There are a number of good designers. Say you're designing a cow shed. If the cow is able to design the cow shed, that's a good design actually. A bit of humorously told, but still this is how I can express by feel what a good design actually is. Yes. Yes, that is the answer for Rajesh's question.
So it's basically from the perspective of the person whoever wants to live there.
What
to live there. It can be an animal, it can be a human or anything like that.
Actually, what I would like to ask.
Yes, Rajesh Agarwal. Yes.
From if we think from a student's or learner's perspective, a student can't understand that if he designs something, if he or she designs something, then he couldn't able to understand that whether his design is good or bad. Actually, so my question is that if from a designer's perspective, if she or he has to understand that whether my design is good or bad, then have you any thoughts about it?
Okay, how should he perceive his design?
Sir, his question is, how does a student understand that whether his design is good or
bad? Perceive. Because most of the time it happens that a student designs something well. And even designing well, he is actually conflicting his design by other designs.
Yeah. No? Correct, Rajesh. Yes.
We need certainly a bit of experience is required to get a hold over a design. To get a hold over a design, to have a 100% understanding of what the full thing will be, and then trying to do a design. And it is, for a student, it is prominently a path of discovery and travel. Discovery, travel, and find out something which he is very new to. Okay, so in this stage, he should be satisfied with his learning. Then he should be doing a number of stages of design and judging by his feel, not judging by ideas, judging by feel. There is just like there is a climax. We have learned about climax in design. So it is hard work and judged by feel in the earlier stages of studentship, which will actually decide whether the design is correct or wrong. See, we also use a method of critiquing by students themselves. They have to come with five negative aspects of their own design. So this neutrality should be there. He should develop this neutrality within him, and then that's how it works.
Sir, actually, what is happening today? We taught our student in many ways. Like if we taught the various works of architects, eminent architects, then like I can say, if an architect is having a signature style, then he is saying that my style is this. He becomes an eminent star by having that particular signature style. Other says that no signature style is required. So actually what happens that students might confuse by having such designers, because every designer, every eminent designers are you can say very well respected for them.
One thing is there is many methods of design. There can be a number of products, there can be a number of ways of innovative designing, but there is something called reasoning, sir.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying, that can you focus on some points about which a student might think that if they are fulfilling that requirements, then that their design become good or bad or even worse.
Some points which that the student should think over, no? Think
yeah, 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 exactly.
Okay.
Apart from the fundamentals which we taught them as theoretical part.
Okay. So that is what I told you. Let him not decide by the thought. He has to decide by a feel. See, if he has done something new, he is certainly happy.
Sir, actually, feel is a very personal matter. What I feel good is not definitely good for you. You are getting my point, what I am saying. Feel is a very personal point.
Yeah, I think, sir, what Rajesh Agarwal is trying to say is the student understands a different architect and his style. And he still doesn't understand whether what is his style. He can't find out what the student's style is. That's is that right, Rajesh?
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, so that is a small thing, and
which style
which we all have.
Yeah. And which style they will follow?
Correct.
Okay. So this 100% learning, this 100% synthesis, 100% collation of a number of things leads to a unique design. This uniqueness works in every project. Then he will have a set of principles, and then he'll have a set of principles, and these principles will lead to a kind of a form or a kind of combination of various tectonics, which will be the language of the student. This is something which we talk about now, but it needs to be achieved over work. Like you mentioned, it needs to be achieved over work. So it might take a little long for certain people. It might be a little closer for certain people. So that is how it is.
Okay. Rajesh Agarwal, sir, I would advise you to contact our team, and you can have the email ID of Ranganathan sir also. You can actually contact him more on the mail, and you can actually converse better.
Exactly.
Because we're having little time here. That's the only issue.
Yeah. I understand.
But good question, sir. Thank you for engaging with your questions, sir. I really appreciate it from your
side. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Ranganathan sir, can you hear me? I think we've taken our session. I think it's gone to 50 minutes. So I think, sir, Ranganathan sir, if you can hear me, we can continue. Arun, it's 4:50. Can we end the session, because Ranganathan sir is out of the video? I think he should have some problem with the video. I think he was telling already. Yes. So guys, the questions of Mahalakshmi Vardarajan and the other person who is there here, right? Mahalakshmi Vardarajan and Jagdish Kasi. I think we can answer your questions via mail. I'll take these questions from the screen. I just take it as a screenshot and keep. After which this session, I will put a word to Ranganathan sir about these questions, and or you can just send a text to the number which we have in the poster, telling your name and your email ID. So we can actually answer the question. Sir can answer the question you via mail, or you can even contact him later on the days to come also. So I think today we've come to the end of this session for the second series of Sasi Creative Schools webinar for the prospective students and also for everybody. So I thank you everyone for attending this session. And if you have any doubts or any further queries of how to contact this person, the person Ranganathan sir who had taken the webinar, you can contact our number which is there in the poster, and we will help you to get his contact, and you can learn a lot from him also. So I think we can end the session today. Thanks a lot everybody for coming. Arun, thank you for supporting. Okay, thank you guys. Let's leave the session. Thank you.